What is going on, Diablo 2 fans? Dabrunski here, and today I'm wrapping up my rumor tutorial video guide series with the Hell Difficulty Edition. So I'm going to split these rumors into three different tiers, the first being kind of your entry tier level, kind of easy to farm, easy to make, but very powerful. The second is going to be mid-tier, so one high rune, nothing more than that, but still kind of meta rumors that you will see on pretty much every build. And the final tier is going to be your godly GG multiple high rune rumors that are going to let you minimax your characters to the full potential in Hell Difficulty. So that is kind of the basis for this video. Quick reminder though, for those that don't know, I do stream twice a week on Twitch. So if you guys do enjoy this YouTube content, just want to remind you guys that you can hit me up with a follow on that platform. Got the link for my Twitch channel in the description below, twitch.dabrunski125. But other than that, guys, I really hope you enjoyed this video. Let's jump in. The first tier of rumors that I want to talk about are Countess farmable rumors. So everything is going to be Blow and Istrune, and these are all going to be powerful rumor choices that you can use to make your character a lot stronger as you begin Hell Difficulty and sort of progress to the late endgame of min and maxing. A lot of these rumors actually are used on endgame builds, so it's definitely something to keep in mind as well, that you want to try and make these as early as you possibly can. The first rumor is Treachery. Shale, Fall, and Lem, it has a lot of increased attack speed and chance to proc Fade. When struck, this is going to give your mercenary, or if you choose to use it on your character, a lot of DR and extra resistance. So this is a very popular rumor choice for mercenaries. Highly recommend you make it with the first lem rune that you drop. The next rumored is Oath. Shale, Pull, Lum, and Mal. And it also has the indestructible mod on this rumored, so you can roll it in ethereal weapons for an insane amount of extra ED. This is going to be the most powerful choice of a melee rumored, below kind of like the best Grief and Breath of the Dying choices, so definitely should make Oath if you're playing in a melee build. Duress is also another popular body armor as well that has Crushing Blow, faster hit recovery, open wounds, all resistances. It's a really kind of popular kind of mini fortitude choice, and you should definitely make it again for more melee-oriented playthroughs. Insight. I mentioned Insight in the previous Nightmare installment video, but the key thing to note about Insight is that it's very cheap to roll, so you want to try and roll this in an ethereal elite polearm base as you progress through Hell Difficulty. A quick little tip here is if you drop an ethereal Colossus Vulge, if you Larzik this, it'll give you a guaranteed 4 open sockets. So it's a really easy way to make a hard-hitting, desirable base to make Insight. One kind of downside about a Colossus Vulge though is it requires a lot of strength, so you're going to have to hunt for other plus strength on gear like your helmet, or you're going to have to be a very high level, so your mercenary won't be able to use it very early on. That's kind of like the catch 22. It's easy to get those four open sockets, but it has a high strength requirement, so just keep that in mind if you're going to Larzik this base. And the final rumored is Spirit and a Monarch Shield. Again, I covered Spirit in the previous episode, but Spirit and a Monarch Shield, you can't drop that base until Hell Difficulty. It's the lowest strength requirement shield that can roll four open sockets, and the earliest you can drop it is Hell, so that's why I didn't cover rolling Spirit in a shield in the Nightmare Edition. So you should definitely, once you get a Monarch Shield, roll the Rumored Spirit, because this is going to be the number one choice of any endgame caster build is Spirit, minus those that want to go max block. You'll probably typically roll Storm Shield. But one important point, or sort of like tip about rolling a Spirit and a Monarch Shield, is that if you Larzik a plain white Monarch base, it will give you a guaranteed 4 open sockets every time. So again, another easy way to get that Spirit Shield base if you really want to, although I recommend saving your Larzik quests, but again, that's totally up to you guys. The following tier of rumors are going to be ones that require at least one high rune and are, in my humble opinion, pretty much mandatory for almost every caster or melee build as you kind of like gear up through Hell Difficulty. So the first one I'm going to cover is Heart of the Oak. This is, of course, the single best overall caster weapon. So yes, there is some specific choices that might be better in very unique scenarios, like Oculus might be better for pure magic finding, Death Fathom might be better for pure cold damage, but the overall number one caster rumored is Hodo for one Vex Rune. This is a great addition to like a Wind Druid, Sorceress, Hammerdin, you name it. It is your go-to all-around best caster rumored. So I do highly recommend you guys roll this one when you get a Vex Rune. The second one is Call to Arms. Every single non-barbarian character uses Call to Arms and Spirit on the offhand for that Battle Order's buff. The health is honestly irreplaceable. Now, one important point to note about the comparison between Call to Arms and Hodo, I always stress rolling Call to Arms first, because even if you roll like one to Battle Orders, With enough decent plus skill gear, you're going to get a pretty big boost to your overall plus life. So say you have Spirit and a Crystal Sword, Spirit and a Monarch Shield, that's plus 4 to skills. You might have, let's say, Lore and a Viper Magi, that's another plus 2 skills. And then plus 1 to your Battle Lures, that's a level 7 bow, which is going to be substantially like a big boost to your life compared to not having it. So definitely, I think that you're better off rolling CTA versus HOTO first. Again, I've mentioned that many times. A lot of people disagree, but I'm going to advise you guys to roll that Rune Bird first. The next two are going to be focused on melee builds. So the first is Grief. Grief in a Phase Blade is the number one melee Rune Bird for 99% of builds. The only kind of one exception I can think of is the Fury Druid, but pretty much every single other build, like the Zealot, Whirlwind Barbarian, Frenzy Barbarian, your go-to Rune Bird is Grief. So for the expense of one low rune, you definitely want to roll this Rune Bird in a Phase Blade as soon as you can. And then of course we have Fortitude. This is the best body armor for your mercenary and the best body armor for pure damage melee builds. For again, the expense of one low rune, you're definitely going to want to roll this combination of Fortitude and Grief for either your mercenary or for a melee focused build as soon as you have a couple of low runes. So the third and final rune classification that I'm going to go over is the sort of min-max, grind your face off, very expensive, multiple high rune segment. The first one that I'm going to cover is Infinity. Burmal, Burist. This rune word is typically always used on mercenaries for damage dealing elemental builds. So Javazon, Trapsin, Lightning Sorceress, even a Blizzard Sorceress, you need this rune word to really maximize your damage and break monster immunities. Super expensive, but if you want to play like end game Chaos Sanctuary solo, you know, Javazon farming or whatever, you need this rune word to break immunities. There's no way around it, unfortunately. The next rune word is Enigma. This grants you teleport to any character class outside of a sorceress. It is quite expensive to roll, but it is literally mandatory for top tier min max efficiency builds. So characters like the Wind Druid, you can play Wind Druid without Enigma, but you really do need it to make like the character maximize its efficiency. That's the best way to put it. Like a summon necro to teleport, to reposition your mercenaries, to telestomp your summons on top of monsters so they do more damage. You need this rune word Enigma. Unfortunately, if you don't think you'll invest the time to grind out and roll this rune word, I highly recommend that you display a sorceress or accept the fact that you will not have top tier efficiency on battle if that is important to you. The next rune word is Beast. This one is very interesting. It's really only typically used on a summon necro. There's a few other very niche case uses of it, like the offhand of a wolf barb. I don't think a lot of you guys will be playing wolf barb, so really if you guys want a top tier summon necro, you're going to want to roll this rune word for that additional fanaticism aura. And the last one that I'm going to cover is also another sort of niche case use. It is Chains of Honor. It grants you 2 to all skills and a massive amount of resistances and damage reduction. This rune word is typically used on characters that are taking on Uber Tristram that really want to stack some additional res to counteract Mephisto's Conviction Aura. It is not mandatory, but if you want to make a smiter that will not die at Uber Tristram, Dole on Burist is going to be the rune word you want to make. Chains of Honor, that 65 all res, is honestly irreplaceable for Uber Mephisto if you want that really tanky, dedicated torch farming character. Well guys, there you have it. That wraps up today's video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it and you found it very informative. Again, let me know in the comment section below if you guys think I missed anything major. I do think that the majority of rune words that I hit up in this video cover all of the meta. There is obviously a lot more rune words than what I listed in today's video, but the main stuff I think I focused on for casters and melee builds was included in this video. But again, I always read the comments, so if I missed something major, let me know, call me out on my stupidity. And as always, if you guys could throw a like on this video, share it, and even consider subscribing if you're new to my channel. I post new weekly content on YouTube and I do stream twice a week on Twitch. So any follows on Twitch or subs on YouTube would be amazing. Other than that, guys, I hope you have a fan-frickin-tastic day and I'll catch you on my next video or live stream. Peace out.